We start here with the learn. We will learn here the micro strip line, and what do you mean by the strip line? Okay, that is about, or we can say that the microwave, that is about small, or we start with it micro strip. So now generally a general purpose PCB, if you consider, it is about a single sided conducting one, and that conducting copper that is placed or deposited on the substrate. If you take a two sided PCB. So above conducting plane, below conducting plane, and in between there is a substrate. This is about a conducting plane. So now we need to design a strip line. Okay, this is about a strip line. Using what? A two-sided PCB. Means we have a line is to be developed, or line is to be designed on this particular PCB, so that line will be act as a strip line. Or you can say that is about a line, or you can say that supposed to be, this is about our conducting line. Only we have designed some particular specific line. This is about a line structure we designed. And this PCB line is nothing but a conducting one. Okay, everything is nothing but a conducting. So that is called as a line. And this line is present in a single plane. Okay, this is about nothing but a plane for the given line. We can say that this is about one particular plane. That's why you can say that a line is called as a planar line, or you can say that planar transmission line. So if you consider that in general, okay, if you see that in general, what happened to the transmission line? In general, transmission line, that is about a two wire. Okay, it is about a two wire line. Two wire means what? We can consider a coaxial cable, inner conductor and outer conductor. Now, in the case of an inner conductor, that is the copper is placed, okay, that is the central conductor, and based on this, the diameter of that particular conductor, current capacity will change. Okay, and we have an outer conductor, or you can say that outer conductor is looks like a mesh and all. So, we can consider this type of a line, okay, two wire line, transmission line, that is an coaxial cable, or we can say that two wires running parallelly, that is nothing but a two wire line. But here in a microwave, we learn a microstrip line or a strip line. That strip line is present in a given particular plane. Now this one, this structure. So it is in a given particular plane. So that's why we can say that the body planar line. Okay. So that this one is designed. Okay, this line is designed on a printed circuit board. Or okay, that is nothing but what we can say, that is about a general particular structure. We can say that a microwave integrated circuit on the particular board there. And this particular setup is to be designed on a PCB. That's why you can say that a monolithic microwave integrated circuit that is designed, and that designs are based on the type of a transistor or a type of a device, or we can say that a type of. So generally, we should know that what are the various types of this particular transmission line structures we can design. Generally, a transmission line structure, all the structures are nothing but a planar one. That's why you can say that we need to learn about a planar transmission line. Okay. So now, in that case, if you consider that, there are the various types of structures we can design. And that structures are nothing but what? Can say that the structures are nothing but what? A strip line. In a single particular line, a particular plane. So that's why we can design a strip line. Then we can say that is about a micro strip line. Okay, then we can say that a coplanar line. Then we say that another one is about a slotted line. Or we can say that a slot line. Now, these are the various lines or coplanar line or coplanar waveguide. Okay, so some people say that it is about a waveguide, coplanar. Now, in this particular structure, everything, whatever the conducting is there, conducting surface, or we can say that a conductor design, whatever the structures we are designing, all these structures in a particular plane. That's why it is called as a planar transmission line. Okay, it is in a physical plane, that's why it is called as a planar transmission line. Now, how that strip line looks like? If you see that here, in a strip line, what happens? Whatever the transmission line structure is there, that conducting line structure is there, that is present at the center. And here we have a substrate. And this particular portion is nothing but a ground. Okay, so this is about your strip line. So now this one is about your center conductor. And here these are the nothing but this is nothing but all this is nothing but a ground plane. And this is nothing but a center conductor for a given particular line. And here this region is nothing but a substrate. This region is nothing but what you can say a substrate. And this substrate, it has nothing but the, okay, that is about a medium constant, that is about ethanol, or you can say that a dielectric constant. The substrate, or you can say that a dielectric substrate. So it has the ethanol R is the dielectric. Now this portion is a conducting one, okay, or you can say that this will be, this new portion is act as a ground, and this is a line. This is about a strip line is to be there. Now a microstrip line, what in a microstrip line, this what happened here, if you supposed to be consider that how to design this particular line, okay, so now you take a paper, okay, now this is nothing but our paper here, hold it. Now, in this case, this one is nothing but a light. Okay. This one is nothing but a light. And this white portion is nothing but what? Conducting one, below is nothing but a conducting. And in between this one, this particular place is nothing but a substrate. So, this is about a transmission line. We can consider. Now, in a microstrip line, what happened? Here, this one is a ground plane. Okay. And above the ground plane, you can consider that above this ground plane, there is a small portion of what we can say a conducting line. This is nothing but a line. And this completely, this one is nothing but your substrate. It has the epsilon. That is, this one is called as a what we can. Okay, microstrip line, and this one you can say that is about a strip line, and a slot line is what we have, a ground plane here, this one is nothing but a ground plane, and above the ground plane there is a substrate. And we say that this is nothing but a small slot. This one is nothing but a conducting one. And this in between this particular region, that is called as a epsilon. Okay, and this one is called as what we can say. This one is, we need to say that is about your slot line. Okay, these are nothing but a conducting one. All these are the particular portions are nothing but a conducting one. This is a ground conducting plane, or you can say a ground plane here. This one is about a conducting wire, or you can say that is about a two wire. And in between these two wires, there is a slot. That's why you can say that is about a slot line. It is about a strip in between the particular substrate. The strip line, microstrip line, small line is there that is posited on your, okay, that is about your, you can say that is about conducting wire is there, okay, that is called as a microstrip. And a coplanar line, coplanar waveguide, so in that case, what happens here? We have a line, that is, we can say that is about a coplanar. Okay, so nothing is there, okay, everything is common, same. This one is about a complete substrate. This one is about a complete substrate, we can say. Okay, this is about your complete substrate we have. And then above that, okay, above that there is a conducting wire, we can see. This is about a conducting wire, we see. Like, so now this one wire is about a conducting wire. Okay, likewise. You can say that this one is about a coplanar line, and we can say that a line will work. Okay, or we can say that a coplanar waveguide. Coplanar waveguide or a coplanar line. Now here we have say that line, small line, this is about a small, this is about a line. Now for each and every configuration, if you consider that, so all these two wire transmission line, if you consider this one about a two wire transmission line, these two wire transmission line, they are characterized by what you can say, characteristic impedance and a propagation transfer. Now for analyzing the circuit, for analyzing this two wire line, we use this characteristic impedance and a transfer. Now in this particular case, in a transmission line, same thing is there. So analyze circuit, analyze the microstrip line or a strip line, we need to know about what will be the characteristic impedance and what will be the propagation cost. Characteristic impedance here in this particular microstrip line, it is depending upon that what will be the strip conductor and what will be. Now, in general, if you consider a two-wire transmission line, or coaxial cable, that characteristic impedance is dependent upon the parameter, what is the resistance, what is the inductance, what is the capacitance, what is the transformer. So, in general, this is about a two-wire line. So, same concept is there in this particular strip line. Here, this is about whatever the dimensions of your particular strip here, this line. Based on this particular dimension, we can find out what will be the characteristic impedance of this particular line. Generally, we should know that for a given particular line, for this particular strip line here, this is a small thin film is there. Okay, very, very small thin film is there. And this is about a small thin film. It is to be developed by photolithography technology. Okay. So this one we can design. So when we use this particular strip line here, so now what will be the length of this particular strip? What will be the size, height, width, and everything? Based on that, we can calculate that what will be the characteristic impedance of this particular line. Then for a transmission line, we say that the mode of transmission, or you can say that, or mode of a propagation. So in this case, mode of a propagation means what? A T mode, TM mode, or a TM mode. So generally, in a transmission line, it just use a TM mode of a transmission, or we can say that a quasi TM mode of a transmission. Okay, quasi TM mode of a transmission, or we can say that's about a TM mode. Okay, hello, all of you. Now for a line. Okay, if you consider that, we need to know about what is the mode of a propagation. Generally, we know that a T mode or a TM mode, E mode or a TM mode of a propagation is possible in a waveguide. But in the case of a two-wire transmission line or this particular microstrip line, if you consider, it supports only a TM wave. Okay, or you can say that is about a quasi TM mode of a propagation is possible in this particular. Okay, particular line. So we will start here with this particular strip line, and then we will conclude with this. Okay. We start with a particular strip line there. Now, generally, what happens in a strip line? We have already I told you. This one is about a ground plane. strip line. One is about nothing but a ground plane we have. All is nothing but you can say it is about a ground. And in between this, same here, and in between this particular ground plane, there is a conductor. You can say that this one is about a conductor here. Now for this particular conductor, it has some particular thickness. And this particular conductor has some width. Okay, so you can say that for a given particular line, that length is different right now. Just say that it has a width and this particular thickness. This is about your conductor. And in between this particular conductor, okay, so there is a substrate present. And this is there nothing but a, but you can say that the height of this particular substrate. Or you can say that everything is includes a substrate here. And substrate has a dielectric constant, a epsilon r. So in general, while designing the strip line, that width should be greater than, very, very greater than thickness. If width will be a small as compared to the thickness, so it will be a small line. Okay. And this one is nothing, this strip line, if you consider that, it is about a two ground planes, you can say. They are nothing but a two ground plane, and these two ground planes are separated by a dielectric medium, and in between that particular dielectric medium or a substrate, there is a strip line. Okay, so that is a very small strip or a small metallic strip, or you can say that is about a conducting strip. So now this is nothing but a, what you can say, it this one ground plane is conducting, another ground plane it is again a conducting. One is about a center conductor, okay, or metallic conductor we can say. So again another conductor means there are the three conductors, 1, 2, and 3. That's why the name generally for this particular strip line, some books they say that it is a triplet, okay, triplet line. This has a triple conductor there, triple conductor present in the particular structure. That's why I can say that the about a triplet line, because about a ground plane, these two ground planes, and one is about a metal. And in between that ground plane, there is a metal conductor, or you can say that is about a conductor material is there, is about a wire is there. And this wire, or you can say that this, it has a width, whatever the width we say, it should be very, very greater than the particular thickness of this particular conductor wire or particular strip. Okay, that is about it. And this ground, two ground planes, are separated by a dielectric substrate, and it has a dielectric substrate of a epsilon r. So now if you consider that for a particular line, that characteristic impedance and a propagation constant all are depending upon that the factors of your whatever the ground plane and what is the substrate there. Now this particular strip, okay, it is to be present, it is present in this particular dielectric, it is embedded in the particular dielectric medium. Okay, so we just consider that now this is about a pane here, this is about a pane. Okay, this is nothing but a conductor, it is a present inside. So that's why you can say that outer is nothing but outer conductor and inner conductor likewise. So it is just like this wire, this strip is embedded there. So similarly here, this one is a embedded. And then if you consider that, okay, how this line will excite, so we can say that excitation for this particular field component, so we should draw a separate diagram for the excitation. This is about a ground plane we have, this is about a strip we have, and if I draw here the excitation from this conductor, it is nothing but a positive. Emanates from the positive, whatever the electric field are there, it emanates from the positive, terminate at the negative, because since the ground plane is a negative one. Okay, electric field component emanates from the positive plate and terminate at the negative. So this is about your positive plate. Okay, center conductor is nothing but the positive plate. You can say that this one is about the electric field distribution. Okay, that is about, you can say that is about the electric field. Because it emanates from there, whatever the, we have the component here. Okay, what is the metallic part? Okay, that is about the center conductor. It emanates from the center conductor and terminate at the, that is about, we have a ground plane. This one is, but we have a ground plane. So, I am going to put the ground plane. Your line, or you can say that, that is about the electric field line, emanates from the positive plate and terminate at the negative. Similar. Okay, this is nothing but a positive plate, these are nothing but the negative plate. And we can consider the, this one is about electric field distribution, and a magnetic field distribution is nothing but what, here supposed to be a conducting wire, we say, around that there will be a field, okay, around that there will be a field. You can say that this is about a magnetic field, will be around the field. Okay, so likewise, you can say that a magnetic field distribution is nothing but the, around the conductor. That is about, we can say, okay, magnetic field line. Distributions of the magnetic field. That is, blue is nothing but the magnetic field line. Now, here, if a current is propagating through the wire, likewise, and around that there is a field. Okay, you can use a thumb rule to find out the direction of this particular field there. Okay, likewise, similar here. We have a electric field distribution. Similarly, we can say that this one is nothing but the magnetic field distribution. And in between, we say that in between this particular dielectric, in between these two ground planes, there is a dielectric. The dielectric can be anything. Okay, we can have a different dielectric material, and we have it some particular table. We can say that this particular dielectric material, and it has a, but if you consider that in our lab, PCB are using, PCB are used, okay, in India, that PCB is about a FR4 material. Okay, so it has a dielectric constant, if you consider, so it is given the that particular material. Different material, so epsilon r will be a different. So, we just consider that what different types of material we can use as a dielectric, that can be, say Teflon, or you can say that is it. We have a polystyrene, or likewise various materials are there that can be used as a dielectric. So a circuit is designed, whatever the line is designed, and that is present in between the whatever the dielectric. It is embedded in the dielectric. Now, if supposed to be this line, okay, now this one, this one is about, it emanates now. Here it is terminated. But what happened there? Some of the line, okay, it emanates outside. Right, likewise. It emanates, but they are not getting any termination. And that is now nothing but what you can say, that is a, at the edges of this particular conductor, some of the lines will emanate from this particular, but it will not terminate to the given ground plane. Because the ground plane size is a restriction here. Average, but some emanates there, so it will be go outside, and that is called as a fringing effect. Okay, fringe, or you can say that is about, you can say a fringing field. You can say that about a fringing field, because that is a center conductor. From the center conductor, or this particular conductor, edges from through this edges will emanate. Okay, through this particular conductor will emanate, and that. Because of that, a fringing field is present. Okay, it will not terminate anywhere. So that's why we need to consider that the width of this particular ground plane is to be a large. Okay, if it will be a large, maybe likewise suppose. So then they will be terminated. But small section will be, okay, because of the small field that will be present, that will be called as a fringing field. So avoid this particular case. To avoid this particular effect, you can say that the width of that particular ground plane is large, or this particular, whatever the size we have, we consider it is be a smaller one. So in this case, okay, in this case it will be possible to avoid this particular fringing field or fringing effect there. Now here your line, okay, your field is confined in this particular line, okay, so that's why you can say that it will be confined in the given particular material or a dielectric material. So that's why that is called as a TEM mode. Okay, your field means your electric field or magnetic field, it is confined in this particular dielectric material. That is called as a, right, we can say it is nothing but a TEM. That mode is called as a TEM mode. And again, we say that we can avoid it by increasing the this particular spacing there. Okay, we can avoid by increasing spacing. Okay, so this particular, we can say that the spacing is to be increased, or we can say that is about the width of this particular ground plane to be increased there. Now, in general, if we consider the waveguide, it has a cutoff frequency. But here, in the case of a strip line, it doesn't have any cutoff frequency. So, means we can say that it has a zero cutoff frequency. Okay, it has a zero cutoff frequency. So, in general, what we can say? We have a cutoff frequency for TE mode or a TM mode. Since it is a TM mode of a propagation, again it has a zero cutoff frequency. And a guide wavelength, it will be depending upon the your substrate. Okay. Or you can say that what will be the dielectric constant. So generally it is about lambda 0 by what you can say the epsilon r, and phase velocity. Is nothing but okay. The body phase velocity is nothing but equal to what we can say that is about constant c by epsilon. So all these factors are depending upon this about we can say that a lambda g and this particular phase velocity is depending upon the what will be the substrate project. So but if you consider that given particular strip line, so we can say that even if it has a zero cutoff frequency, you can see that zero cutoff frequency, but a conductor is there, okay, small thickness conductor is there, and based on it, what will be the thickness, what will be the size, and everything is there. It has the limitations regarding the frequency, but limitation regarding the frequency, that will be what? Upper frequency limitation. Okay, so it has a upper frequency limitation, and that is because of what we can say that this particular line will not work for the higher order mode. So it will work for the lower order. These limitations regarding only a higher frequency operation. So that's why we can say that the line, okay, we will work only for the low frequency, for the higher order mode, or we can say that higher order mode, or we can say higher order frequency. There are the limitations regarding the frequency, and that limitations are depending upon that what will be the width of the line, what will be the substrate height, and what will be the substrate cost. These are the limitations, and that based on these limitations, you can calculate that what will be the frequency, or you can say that the body cutoff wavelength at particular higher mode. Okay, so we can calculate. But we know that general transmission line, if that line is a lossless transmission line, in general we say that the characteristic impedance is depending upon that phase velocity, and we can say it is depending upon that what is the velocity of the line. But here, in particular strip line, the characteristic impedance is depending upon that what will be the thickness, what will be the height, thickness and what will be the width. So generally, it is going to be considered that a width and whatever the substrate height. So for if we consider that the thickness is very very small, okay, a strip line is there, and it has a very very small, okay, that thickness of this particular line. This one is about a T. T means what we can say that about a thickness. This one is a width. And this one is a about a subset at B. Now, if this line, it has a very, very small thickness, this near about 0. So, then we can calculate that the characteristic impedance with respect to the ratio of what will be the width, okay, what will be the width and what will be the height in between the particular subset, okay, or we can say that the bottom in between the two ground plane, what is the height of the subset or what is the height of this particular two ground plane. So, if the W by B ratio, if you consider that, if it is a less than 0.5, so what is the character impedance? The character impedance for the given W by B ratio, it will be what? 30 by under root of epsilon r natural logarithm of choice of 1 plus under root of c divided by 1 minus under root of c. And we can consider that k is equal to what? K is equal to k is equal to k equal to take hyperbolic of what will be the width we have and what will be the height of the that is nothing but a k. And if we need to find out for that ratio W by B ratio, if it is greater than the point, that case the character impedance is nothing but what? A 30 pi square divided by under root of r natural logarithm of choice of 1 plus under root of k. Okay, that is k dash and 1 minus under root of k. Now this k dash is equal to what? K dash is equal to what? 1 under root of 1 plus k. That is about k dash. So we can obtain the character impedance of a line for the, you can see that the body thickness is small or is large. So according to that, we can consider the character. But in the case of if our line, okay, if the line is not very, very small, the thickness of the given line is not, okay, very, very small. In that case, we can say that a non-zero thickness, okay, non-zero thickness of this particular line. In the body, earlier we have considered that a thickness is zero, since it is very, very small. Now, if it is, that thickness is not a non-zero value, okay, then the character impedance value will be a difference. So, we can calculate that the character impedance of a line gets different formula there. But if it is a zero there, then we can use a different formula. That's why we can consider that for a zero value or for a non-zero value, a character impedance is different and it can be obtained in the numerical method. Now, if a strip line with a wide center strip, okay, and it has a non-zero thickness, it has a non-zero thickness. For a non-zero thickness of a line, okay, for a non-zero thickness of a line, now for this line, it has a non-zero thickness. In that case, that W by B needs to be greater than 0.35. So, in that case, the characteristic impedance of a line is equal to 94.15 under root of epsilon r and wk by b plus that is about the capacitance, okay, because in between that thickness, okay, we have unique capacitance there, 8.8. One is about your character impedance of the line. So in that case, k is equal to 1 minus what is the thickness by d, and a fringing capacitance Cf is equal to 8.8. Okay, fringing capacitance will be 8.8, or we can calculate the fringing capacitance by using that what is the value of k. Okay, this is what 8.854 r divided by pi into twice k, natural logarithm of k plus 1 minus k minus 1, natural logarithm of k square minus 1. Okay, so this is please get the capacitance. Okay, so that's about it. So there may be a losses. There may be a losses in what? We have a losses in a trip line. So losses in a trip line can be obtained by that's about resistor. Rest by whatever you can say that zero into b and pi that w by b plus natural logarithm of 4 pi by d. Natural logarithm of 2 plus pi w. So this is about a resistance RS depending upon that what is the conducting surface. That's why or a conducting line. So it is nothing but a pi f by so that your signal, or we can say that signal propagates to this particular wire. That's why RS will be there. And this condition of this lambda c, in that case W is greater than twice of B or C is less than U by. Similarly, we can calculate that the attenuation. That's the body. Here we can say that the body conducting or conductor of the attenuation. Okay. Or we can say that conducting loss. Or we can say that okay, dielectric attenuation. The dielectric attenuation is nothing but what? 27.3 tan of del. Right by lambda g. Okay, that is about it. That is about it. Dielectric. So generally, the attenuations are depending upon that what type of conductivity of a conductor is there, or what type of material we are using, and then what will be the resistivity. Okay, what will be the resistivity of this particular conductor, or what will be the epsilon r of this particular dielectric, or we can say that what will happen. Conductor or a particular line whenever we have the magnet resonance. So that is about we say the strip line here. We have seen the strip line. So in that case, we have learned that a character impedance is depending upon that what will be the conducting that will be the width, what will be the thickness, and what will be the height of this particular.